the U.S. Navy veteran turned private eye who has a knack for cracking a case, here to tell us all about the new CW investigative documentary series, Mysteries Decoded. Welcome, Jennifer Marshall. How are you?
Thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate it. Good morning.
We're excited to have you. You were actually asking her.
Yeah, which ship she was on, which carrier, and Theodore,
USS yes.
Theodore Roosevelt.
My second command was the Theodore Roosevelt, yes.
Yeah, and I spent some time on the Theodore Roosevelt in the Arabian Sea.
We barely missed each other.
Yeah. What made you want to go into the Navy?
I graduated from a small one-stop light town, and I thought, I have to get out of here and see what's in the world. And my recruiter called me, and he said, let me pitch the Navy to you. And trust me, there was no pitch required. I just said, how can I enlist? Where do I go?
Really?
Mm. Yeah, for sure.
In that time during your service, did you find that you were privy to classified information?
I think that I did not have a clearance, but there was, at my first command, there was a lot of things that were going on that were not well known. So there were definitely things that I came across that I do not believe that I was supposed to come across. Uh-huh. So for this episode, specifically in Area 51, I really had to pare back what I could say on television.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. That was exactly my question, was does that come into play sometimes in terms of Mysteries Decoded?
It does. And what I learned from the time I left the military, that is all fair game. Mm-hmm. But if I saw something in the military that I'm not sure if it's been declassified, I just prefer to keep that to myself.
Well, will you explain to us what Mysteries Decoded is exactly?
So it's a show. I'm a private investigator in real life. I also have a career in TV and film. And it is me pairing up with an investigator, somebody who's really specific about that field. We're going to investigate historical mysteries and seeing what really happened.
That's exactly right. So a big topic that has been obviously in the news, but you guys are going to be discussing is preparing to storm Area 51.
Yes.
Tell me how you're going to deal with that issue.
You know, we had originally filmed the episode before that was a movement. So we did go back and we refilmed many segments of it. But this is a very dangerous proposition. I understand the kind of fun nature behind it, but this is a active military base, and they will use non-lethal force, but lethal force if necessary. So do not do that. Do not cross
right.
the gate.
They did actually release a tweet saying the exact same thing.
Yes.
Let's take a look at a clip of you in Mysteries Decoded. Mm-hmm.
The wind. The wind's 120
knots to the west.
Oh, big
damn. That's
not
an LNS,
though, is it?
Well,
if there's a
I'm speechless.
Okay. First impression. Shape.
No, first impression was it rotated.
It rotated.
Look at the way it rotated.
Yeah. Could conventional aircraft rotate like that mid-flight?
There's no way that an aerial vehicle could do that while maintaining altitude and velocity. It's not going to rotate like that.
Jennifer. Mm.
But what was it? I mean, do you come to maybe you probably can't tell us, but do you come to an actual decisive conclusion of what that was?
Well, I'll say that we talked to a lot of people. We talked to a CIA operative. We talked to a pilot who's an aeronautical engineer. Mm-hmm. We talked to a lot of experts to say, what is this that we're seeing and why was it released by the government?
Right.
Because that's the big thing. It was released by the government, so that makes me believe they don't know what it is. Boeing doesn't know, Lockheed Martin doesn't know, and that actually is very terrifying.
Wow. Mm.
Because if we don't know where this came from...
Well, that's the best tease I've ever heard
for
a show.
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you so much, Jennifer, coming in. Mysteries Decoded airs tonight at 9 p.m.
It's
right here. On
we
this
got it.
We actually have a show.
We got the show.
That's exactly right. As Mark said, he's all excited. We got it.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Jennifer.
Yes, thank you for having me.
Great to meet you.